feels like the winds are gonna change beneath my feet. The earth is ready. I know it's time for heaven's rain. It's gonna rain. Living water we desire to flood our hearts with holy fire. Rain down all around the world and we're singing. Rain down. Can you hear the earth is singing? Rain down. My heart is dry but still I'm singing. It's time to dream again. I see the clouds, and yes, I'm ready to dance upon this barren land. Hope in my hands, yeah. Living water we desire to flood our hearts with holy fire. Rain down all around the world we're singing. Rain down. Can you hear the earth is singing? Rain down. My heart is dry but still I'm singing.
Fascinating to see how the word gives such invaluable insights to deal with so many business challenges.
We take different career paths and we do different things that motivate us. But through it all, we realize that God's vision is timeless.
Creativity knows no bounds if God's the central focus. That's why I chose dancing as a career.
I realize a strong spiritual foundation so important to build a team.
When your core values are rooted in the Word, you are confident of your work ethics.
Come, join us
as we explore
and study together
the timeless principles
for the workplace.
Greetings and thank you for tuning in to Living Strong today. As always, it's a joy and a delight to come your way and bring God's Word to you. We are in the middle of an exciting series called Timeless Principles for the Workplace, where we are looking at God's Word and exploring principles from the Word of God that are relevant and applicable to our places of work. Most of us spend a lot of our lives in the workplace, where we are engaged in various industries or various roles in the workplace, and we need principles that will undergird our professional practices and our daily lives, in fact. Principles which do not change with time or place or culture or region of the world, that these principles are still valid and they still hold. And so we are looking at the Word of God and understanding the principles of the Word of God that we can use for the workplace. All of this entire teaching is available in a book, which you could request for free. If you'll just send us your postal address, we'll be happy to send it to you. Or you could download that book from our church website, and please use that to follow along with us on these series. On each telecast, we'll be able to cover a few main points. We won't be able to deal with the entire subject, but if you'll be able to study the book, you will be able to get a lot more on each topic that we address on these telecasts. On the program today, we want to talk about right workplace attitudes. As we begin our professional journey, it is important to have the right attitude towards our work and in our workplace. You know, though, our attitude simply means how we look at things and how we act and react in different situations. And attitudes really matter, because your attitude almost always determines your altitude. How far you would go professionally is not only tied or not only related to your professional knowledge and skills, but it's also related in some measure to the attitude that you have in your place of work. How you look at things, how you relate to people, it depends. It also affects how much you grow professionally. Think about Daniel. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 6 and verse 3 that this Daniel distinguished himself above the governors and the rulers, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought of setting him over the whole realm. So here was Daniel. He was working in a very difficult environment. He was actually working in Babylon, which was not his home country. He was working in the palace of, he worked in the palace of three different king emperors, the Babylonians, the Medes, and then the Persians. Now, here's a record of how he had an excellent spirit, and he carried himself in such a way, he worked in such a way that he distinguished himself above all the other people around him, so that the king said, you know, I need to make this man in charge of my entire empire. So your attitude, the spirit with which you do things, that excellent spirit, that good attitude, can really make cause you to be distinguished and stand out. And that's what we want to talk about. Here are some basic things as a Christian, as a believer in the workplace. Here are some basic things which all of us as believers must, attitudes that we must carry to the workplace. And I will just go mention some of these things. First of all, we have an attitude where we are doing all to the glory of God. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 10 verse 31, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it to the glory of God. So that's one attitude, our approach to work, that whatever I do, whether I'm a software developer, whether I'm a businessman, whether I'm a salesperson, whether I'm, you know, the CEO of an organization, whatever I'm involved in, whatever I do, I'm doing it to glorify God. I'm doing it so that God will be honored through this. Keep your ambition kingdom focused. That's another important attitude. That means what I do, I want to in some way channel it and use it for God's kingdom. So keep your ambition, what you become in the workplace, what you become professionally, keep your ambition kingdom focused. Jesus told us this in Matthew 6:31. He said, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. So my first priority, the thing that I'm really after, first thing, is God's kingdom. How can God's kingdom, God's rule and God's reign be extended in my life and through my life in what I'm doing? So keep your ambition, even your professional ambitions, keep it kingdom focused. If you're a mid-level manager and you want to become vice president, become president, and become the CEO of your organization, that's wonderful. But keep it kingdom focused, meaning through all of this, I want God's kingdom to come forth. Always remember that there is more to life than making money. See, this is a problem for us in the professional world. We think, you know, money is the ultimate reward for our work. Now, money, of course, is important, but there is more to life than just making money. The Bible says in Proverbs 11, verse 28, he who trusts in riches will fall, but the righteous will flourish like foliage. You're just putting your trust in riches and putting all your desire for riches, it's very short-lived. There's more to your professional life than just making money. And so learn to look at the big picture. Learn to look at what God wants through your professional life. And always walk in the fear of the Lord. You know, no matter what position you hold in your organization, no matter what role you have, no matter what kind of work you do, whether it's something inside your office, whether it's something outside meeting people, always walk in the fear of the Lord. Proverbs 15 and verse 16 says, better is a little with the fear of the Lord than great treasure with trouble. You know, better to walk in reverence for God in all your things, in your business dealings, in your sales contracts, in your financial accounting procedures, in all your dealings, walk in the fear of the Lord. Because it's better to have something that's been done with the fear of the Lord than to have many riches and only have a lot of trouble. What's the point of that? So always walk in the fear of the Lord. These are attitudes, these are perspectives we don't want to lose as we engage professionally. The fruit of the Spirit are winning attitudes. So if you want to think about this, you know, what are attitudes that I must have, which are winning attitudes that will make me a winner? The answer is very simple. You walk in the fruit of the Spirit, and those are winning attitudes. Those will help you stand out in any day, in any place. What is the fruit of the Spirit? Galatians 5, 22 and 23 gives us the fruit of the Spirit. It talks about love. The fruit of the Spirit is love. It's joy, it's peace, it's patience, it's kindness, it's goodness, it's faithfulness, it's humility and self-control. These are the nine fruit of the Spirit. And as you walk in these things, even in your professional life, it'll make you a winner. These are winning attitudes. Walking in love at all times, being patient with people, being kind to people, walking in humility, walking in self-control. These are attitudes that if we carry even into the workplace, it'll make us winners. So the fruit of the Spirit are winning attitudes. Now the Bible teaches us how to work in our workplaces. Let's look at one passage here in Ephesians 6 verses 5 through 8. And the key thing that we learn there is that we must do our work obediently, sincerely, willingly, cheerfully. Do your work obediently, sincerely, willingly, cheerfully. And this brought to us in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 5 through 8. The Bible says this, it says, slaves, obey your human masters with fear and trembling, and do it with a sincere heart, as though you were serving Christ. Do this not only when they are watching you, because you want to gain their approval, but with all your heart, do what God wants as slaves of Christ. Do your work as slaves cheerfully, as though you serve the Lord, and not merely human beings. Remember that the Lord will reward each of us, whether slave or free, for the good work we do. Now, of course, the language is slightly different. In Bible times, there were owners, and there were householders, and they were slaves or servants. In today's world, the workplace is different. We call them bosses and employees or employers, and we use different language. But it's talking about the workplace. And it says, when you go to your work, do your work with sincerity, obey with obedience, do what your bosses or your managers tell you to do. Do it as though you are serving Jesus. Do it as unto the Lord, not just your boss. And it says, do it even when they're not watching, and when your bosses are not watching, you be faithful, you be sincere. Do it willingly and do it cheerfully. So this is what the Bible says. Now you carry this kind of an attitude into your workplace. And what an impact it will make. You will stand out as an employee. Another important part of the workplace is loyalty. Loyalty is essential. Be faithful. In Proverbs chapter 3 verses 3 and 4, the Bible says, never let go of loyalty and faithfulness. Tie them around your neck, write them on your heart. If you do this, both God and people will be pleased with you. See, loyalty is a very difficult commodity, especially in the professional world. You know, people keep jumping jobs every year, every couple of months. And that sense of loyalty is so weak today. But if you and I, if we walk in loyalty to our organization, to the team that we work in, to the projects that we're involved. We walk in loyalty. It says even God and man will notice you and will bring honor into your life. So loyalty is an essential commodity. Walk in it. Now, when we say loyalty, I'm not saying that, you know, once you join an organization, you're committed to it for the rest of your life. That's not what we're saying. What we're saying is, as long as you're in it, you be loyal to your organization, do your work well, and stay faithful to the cause and the purpose of your organization. So loyalty is a very essential thing. And loyalty is really expressed through faithfulness. That's the Bible word, faithfulness. And Jesus talked about it in Luke 16, and he talked about the unjust steward. And at the end of that, he talked about faithfulness in different things. He talked about being faithful in small things, small matters, faithful in handling money, and faithful in what belongs to somebody else. So loyalty is demonstrated through these things, your faithfulness, your handling these things correctly. Even small tasks that are given to you, you handle them faithfully. You handle money that's entrusted to you, you handle that faithfully. Handle what belongs to somebody else. When somebody delegates a task to you, you do that well. And this demonstrates faithfulness. And the Bible tells us in Proverbs 28 and verse 20 that a faithful man will abound with blessings. Man who is faithful, he will have many blessings on his life. Be accountable at all times, even when you're not being watched or when you're not being asked for it. Accountability, doing your work with a sense of accountability is a very important thing. Be passionate. If your heart is not in it, then you either get in or you get out. So we need to be passionate about our work. And there's got to be this attitude of an enthusiasm and passion for what you're doing. In Proverbs chapter 11 and verse 8, the Bible says, bad work gets paid with a bad check. Good work gets solid pay. So bad work, doing something, you know, just for the sake of doing it with a, you know, almost disinterested. You can tell when somebody's heart is not in the work they're doing. But good work, somebody who's put their heart into what they're doing, Bible says they get a good pay, get a solid pay. And so that can make a lot of difference. If people see that you're really passionate about your work, you're committed to it, and you're doing it with all your heart, you're giving it your 100%, you know, they'll be happy to reward you. They'll be happy to pay more. But if they see it's half-hearted, then I don't think we have a real right to expect for more. So be passionate for your work. The book of Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 10 says, whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might. I mean, whatever you put your hand to, do with all your energy, do it with enthusiasm, do it well. Maintain integrity and truthfulness always, in all things. That's an important attitude, a workplace attitude, that we say, you know, whatever I do, I want to do it with integrity. I want to do it with honesty. Proverbs 10 and verse 9 says, he who walks with integrity walks securely. But he who perverts his ways will become known. In other words, when you're walking with integrity, that's your best place of security. Nobody can point a finger at you. Nobody can topple you down. But when you pervert your ways, when you do things that are not right, you are going to be exposed, and it's going to bring a lot of shame. So always, as part of your engagement in the workplace, in your professional life, there's one thing you decide. I'm going to walk with integrity. And there are several scriptures in the Bible that teach us about the importance of integrity and doing things right. And also work hard. There is no substitute for diligence. There is no place for laziness. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 10 and verse 4, he who has a slack hand becomes poor, but the hand of the diligent makes rich. Meaning a person who is working hard, who is diligent, that's what's going to lead him to prosperity. That's what's going to make him more wealthy. But a man who deals with a slack hand, who's not working hard, he's going to only become poor. He's going to diminish in what's happening. So work hard. The Bible also tells us in Proverbs 12 and verse 24, the hand of the diligent will bear rule, but the lazy man will be put to forced labor. So do you want to be a leader, or do you want to just keep working for somebody else? Here's the difference. Diligence. The person who's diligent, he is going to rise up. He's going to go into leadership positions. But a person who deals with a slack and who's lazy, he's only going to work for somebody else and keep receiving instructions. Another important workplace attitude that we would like to keep in mind is that what you do with your time is up to you. Don't waste it. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 28 and verse 19, a hardworking farmer has plenty to eat. People who waste time will always be poor. So time is in your hands. The time in your work is there. be productive with your time. Put your time to the best use. But a person who wastes his time, the Bible says, will only diminish, will only become poor. He'll only see waste. Have a passion for excellence. Work in your workplace. Let people see that you're passionate for excellence. Not just doing your work, but doing your work with excellence. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 22 and verse 29, observe people who are good at their work. Skilled workers are always in demand and admired. They don't take a back seat to anyone. So the skillfulness in your work, people who are excellent in their work, what'll happen? They'll be in demand. They are the ones others will want. And they're the ones who will come into the forefront. They're the ones who will come into leadership. They're the ones who will be entrusted with responsibility and positions of leadership in their organizations. And they're very skillful and they're excellent in what they do. Never stop learning, never. An important attitude to take to your workplace is that every day you're going to learn something. You're going to learn something new. You're going to learn something about your business, about the marketplace, about people, about how to handle problems, how to make decisions. Every day is a learning experience. The Bible says in Proverbs 1 and verse 5, a wise man will hear and increase learning. A man of understanding will attain to wise counsel. You know, who's a wise man? He will always keep learning. He'll always be willing to listen. He's attentive. He's always learning. And that's the attitude we must have, an attitude where we are always learning, looking to grow, looking to increase. Proverbs 18 and verse 15 says, intelligent people are always eager and ready to learn. So what's a sign of wisdom, a sign of intelligence? You're always eager and ready to learn. Coming into an attitude of learning doesn't mean that you are inferior to anybody else. It only means that you're willing, you're wise, you're willing to acquire knowledge, you're willing to acquire skill so that you can grow. So have an attitude of learning. Never stop learning. Keep that way. I want to close with this one, another workplace attitude. Stay calm, stay focused when the unexpected happens. You know, in the workplace, a lot of unexpected things can happen. Things that you plan may not always go the way you planned it. The goals that you set, you may not always reach those goals. There are a lot of unexpected things can happen. On a day-to-day basis, things can go wrong. Now, it is so important to remain calm and remain focused even when the unexpected happens. You could hear news that you were not expecting to hear. The reports can come in that you were not expecting. A lot of these things, stay calm. The Bible says in Proverbs 3, verses 25 and 26, no need to panic over alarms or surprises or predictions that doomsday is just around the corner, because God will be right there with you. He will keep you safe and sound. So when you have all kinds of predictions, all kinds of alarms, all kinds of surprises that kind of give you bad news, the Bible says no need to panic. Be calm. Stay focused. Why? Because God's right there with you. So in every situation, even when bad news comes, just remind yourself, God's right here with me. So I'm not going to panic. I'm not going to lose control. I'm going to stay calm. I'm going to stay focused. I'm going to see how I can solve this problem, how I can move forward. And God is with me right here to enable me to handle this situation. So we've just covered several workplace attitudes, and I'd encourage you to get this book and study chapter 3, learn more about different attitudes that will really make us employees or employers, people that others would really want to work with and that we can build great organizations.
On today's program, in our study, we used our publication, Timeless Principles for the Workplace. This book deals with a wide range of workplace-related topics to give us a deeper understanding of the underlying principles that guide our professional lives. Write to us to request a free copy of this book or visit our website at www.apcwo.org and download this publication and various other free resources to help you in your spiritual journey.
Thank you so much for being with us on the program today. And we trust that these thoughts here on the workplace attitudes that which the Bible presents to us were encouraging, enriching to your life. We're going to pray together. And as we pray together, I would encourage you to ask the Lord, saying, God, give me a good heart, a good workplace attitude. When I go back to my place of work tomorrow, I want to go there with a good attitude. I want to be somebody others will enjoy being around in the workplace. that I can just enthuse people, I can just encourage people, and I will carry the attitude of Jesus Christ to my place of work. Let's be those kinds of people as we go about our professional lives. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for what your word teaches us. And we thank you for the Holy Spirit who helps us live by the word of God. I pray for especially, Lord, for those who are watching the program today, that God, that you will bring about change in the attitudes, in their perspectives, in the way they act and react to situations, that they will have the attitude of Christ in everything in their workplace, Lord. They'll be able to walk in these things we've learned from your word. And we pray, Father, that others will be blessed because of it. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for being with us on the program today. And until next time, remember, live life the Jesus way.
We invite you to visit our church website, www.apcwo.org, where we provide several free resources, including MP3 sermons, sermon notes, and free publications that you can download and use. You can also call, email, or write to us to request your free printed copy of our publications. Please feel free to share your comments and prayer requests when you contact us.